There we go. Alright, let's turn off the music. No. Because then how will people find us? It's important. Switch over to the LA Noir OBS. Where's the cursor? There it is. Gotta turn the volume back up. Kill the first man I see. Which message, bro? So last time a car ran off a cliff and the driver was drugged. You found a letter from the runaway kid's parents and torn up panties in the car. Thank you. Because, yeah, I wasn't really remembering. Katie decided to go to sleep. She wasn't really up for doing LA Noir, which is fine. I didn't figure she would be. And that's perfectly okay. We all have the things we like and do not like. Oh, God. Sorry. I knocked over an empty water bottle. I should probably make a post. Is this actually loading? There it goes. Alright, let me make a post real quick. Oh, did you guys enjoy that? Was that fantastic? It kind of was. We're done with pigeons. Now let's... Fuck. Just play this, I guess. Some more. There we go. Okay. Let's do this. Honestly, my voice is actually kind of hurting after all that. I like how I spawned into a bush. Oh wow, it's 8-ball down again. Alright, we did get all the clues, didn't we? Did we not get any of the clues? We should have, I saved the game. Yeah, we got some clues. We just didn't talk to everybody, I guess.
Mrs. McAfee, we would like to ask you a few questions, if that's okay.
I prefer to use my maiden name, June Ballard. You might be familiar with.
Not sure what's going on with the frame rate.
Can you tell us what happened here?
You're kind of cute for a cop. Maybe a bit on the serious side.
What about me, June? I'm a big fan of Beast.
You? I don't like. Keep out.
We understand that you're still suffering from the effects of the accident, Mrs. McAfee. The officer says that you claimed that you were drugged. Who did this to you?
That rat slipped us a Mickey Finn. It's no wonder I feel so dopey. I can't remember.
I'm not really buying that. So, what are my things? I'm not buying her face.
I don't believe you, Mrs. McAfee. The story's too far-fetched. I think you were drunk and lost control of the car.
Well, I suggest you get the results of a blood test first before you go shooting off your mouth. Unless you have some other proof.
Yeah, I don't have any proof she was drinking. Driver of crashed vehicle alleges doped.
Don't ask, we never find out. It's a serious offense to withhold information from the police during a criminal investigation, madam.
I told you to call me June. You're making me feel like an old lady. And don't bother your handsome head about this. My husband will settle the score with Mark Bishop.
Okay.
What can you tell us about the passenger in your car?
Jessica Hamilton. Poor Jessica. It's been a rough day for her. She's desperate to break into movies. What more can I say?
What about Jessica? I have something in my thing from Jessica, don't I? Letter signed Camille Hamilton asking Jessica to come home.
I think you're lying, Mrs. McAfee. I think something happened to Jessica yesterday before the crash.
I'm offended, Sunshine. Do you have any proof?
Her panties are in there and they're ripped.
Yeah. Miss Hamilton's underwear were physically torn from her body.
She wanted to go to a casting. I took her to a casting. Whatever happened after that is between her and Mark Bishop.
Nice.
You mentioned a Mark Bishop. You think he might have had something to do with this?
He is a movie producer. As for his involvement, you just leave it to me and my husband to worry.
That's not how police work. Policing works. Although, she looks stone cold serious here.
That's a lie and you know it. This goes deeper than that.
I'm sorry. Maybe you'd like to go ahead and prove that, honey.
Yeah, I don't have any proof of this.
You're off the hook. For now.
You were giving me a thorough going over. I was just starting to enjoy it.
This is a big scene, folks. We need to get our bearings. Let's go see the coroner.
Is this the coroner? Are you the coroner?
They told me to wait on the detectives. But I can't hang around forever.
And it's nice that you can actually back out of that. I didn't know you could.
I knew it wasn't sacred out here anymore.
I didn't know you could back out all the way. Okay, this doctor. What's up, buddy?
Drunk driver?
Maybe not.
How so?
Well, a head I found without a body piqued my interest. See what you think.
What?
Alas, poor Yorick. I knew him, Horatio.
Shut up.
Is it real?
No. I think it's supposed to be a...
Is it real?
Indian shrunken head. It's some kind of curio or movie prop. See the casting marks?
Yeah. I see all the casting marks.
What's it made from?
Plaster of Paris would be my first guess. Then painted.
So we can rule out the murder angle?
No, you can rule that in. That thing was wedging the accelerator to the floor. Whoever did it wanted these women dead.
I see. Neat.
Another day, another dollar.
We should speak to Ballard again. She might not be telling us the whole story.
I like the fact he asked if it's a real... Is he asking if it's a real shrunken head? Or a real prop? I mean, it's real, it's corporal. He has it in his hand. Woof! Hey, I found a head. June Ballard, 41.
We found a shrunken head. It was used to tamper with your car.
You see, I normally don't drive off cliffs. The last thing I remember is getting behind the wheel.
Oh, no. Look at her face. She's not telling the truth. What does the lie say?
Mrs. McAfee, you're lying. Wasting our time. You know what's going on here. You just won't tell us.
I don't have any proof of this.
You're sweet, but simple too. The burden of proof is with the law.
Yeah, I don't have any proof.
Like I made a mistake.
But I can doubt you.
It's obviously some kind of movie prop. You must know where it came from.
In case you hadn't noticed, I am the talent.
And you're a terrible liar.
And the talent doesn't deal with props or sets or any of that kind of stuff. Why don't you ask Mark Bishop which prop house he uses?
Okay, so we got that one. And let's talk about Mark Bishop again.
You mentioned Mark Bishop. You think he might have had something to do with this?
He is a movie producer. As for his involvement, you just leave it to me and my husband to worry about.
I feel like you're not giving this case adequate attention, poor boy.
That's a lie and you know it. This goes deeper than that.
I'm sorry. Maybe you'd like to go ahead and prove that, honey.
So prove what exactly? Prove that it goes deeper? He's a movie producer. He works with the props. So we found the shrunken head wedged there. That seems like proof to me. Damn it.
I'm in pain here, detective. I nearly died. Now you're throwing these stories around here like they're facts?
Nope.
Mrs. McAfee, I think it would be in everyone's best interest if you accompanied Patrolman Gonzalez back to the receiving hospital.
I'm going to be okay. These guys can take me home after my lawyer and I have talked to the news house.
Mrs. McAfee, you are still under the influence of narcotics. You're likely to go into shock once the drugs wear off.
And I thought you were a healer. It's nice of you to be concerned.
I think we're good here. Let's go see if we can shake out of the kid.
All right. I know which car I'm taking. Do I have a address? Excuse me, is Champ there?
Are you blind?
That's a wall. Oh, it's like they deliberately tried not to give you a shortcut there.
You're taking the next left. People might move out of the way quicker if you use the siren.
Shut up, Cole. Whatever the hell your name is. Sobinski.
Cross over, keep going straight.
It's an interesting looking hospital. I like it, actually. What? He has a dumb name. Can't remember.
Hello,
Detective Mikowski.
Phelps, here to interview a Jessica Hamilton.
Jessica Hamilton. Oh yes, she's in the room right behind you, Detective.
All right, it's fancy. White.
You can't hold me here. No, I don't need to be manhandled by a doctor.
Feeling better
I
since this morning,
lawyer.
Jessica.
Hey,
a little.
Where is the telephone? Do you know who I am?
The person yelling, shut up. Alright, Jessica Hamilton, 15, holy hell. Head trauma and soft tissue damage sustained in car accident. Visual traces of chloral hydrate, external bruising to genitals, and other evidence of criminal abuse. Okay. this color pink and perfused, normal. Traces recently administered, don't administer further sedatives without express permission. Okay. Well, oh, was it?
Huh. Making me uncomfortable. Just standing around here looking at me, not saying anything.
I'm not looking at you. Shut up. I'm looking around your room. Oh, that's right. She did say that.
Incidental.
Okay. All right.
I don't think so.
Nope. It's a game about solving crimes. Okay, Wolflover.
My name is Cole Phelps. I'm a policeman. I'd like to talk to you about your accident, if that's okay.
Okay.
It's about hats. I feel like she's not going to be lying.
It's all kind of fuzzy. I remember waking up here. Nothing happened yesterday.
That I don't believe. You are lying.
Tell the truth, Jessica. Why the big cover-up?
I'm not lying to you.
She's so bad at this. All right.
We found your underwear in your handbag, Jessica. You need to tell us what happened.
The doctor told me what happened. I didn't want that. I just wanted to be a star, to be in movies. I told Junie what happened, and she told me to toughen up.
Who's Junie?
That was the price.
That's the lady we talked to, right?
Did she now, cold-hearted bitch?
It's not Junie's fault. It's not my first time. I had a boyfriend back home, but my father found out about him.
All right, she's 15.
Even if you consented, Jessica, you're still underage.
She's 15, and she's already, you know, this is the 40s.
You need to get in touch with your parents, Jessica. Tell them what has happened.
Oh, you don't need to worry then. They sent me along to stay with Aunt June.
You are lying again.
Trust her to take care of me.
This lady is... she's a terrible liar. We have a letter from your mom asking to come home.
You're lying, Jessica. How are we going to make this right if you lie to us?
Please, detective. Why would I lie to you?
You already lied. You lied to my face.
Because you're a runaway, Jessica, and you don't have your parents' permission to be here. Now, do you want to tell me what really happened?
I went with Junie to this strange place. It's difficult to remember. Someone gave me a drink to calm my nerves, and then I felt faint. I think I must have passed out.
So she got Cosby'd. Is that a time we joke?
How did you meet Mr. Bishop?
Welcome back, Cable Father.
Junie is a big movie star. You probably know that. She's doing a new movie.
I believe that. I have no reason not to believe that. Although, why are you giving me shifty eyes? You're hiding something. How do we know Junie?
What's the story with Bishop and Mrs. McCaffrey? Why does he want the two of you dead?
That can't be true. Mr. Bishop seemed very happy today. I mean, yesterday.
And that's why he wedged a shrunken head against the accelerator pedal and punted the two of you over an escarpment.
Escarpment? It's a fancy word.
I overheard Junie speaking to him on the phone a couple of times. Screaming, really. She can be very hard sometimes, Junie. But they seemed okay yesterday, like they worked it out.
This girl has lied to me like 3 times now.
I know what happened with Jessica. Where exactly did it take place?
Please, it's scary. Really difficult to think of anything.
I know I don't have any proof for that, so I'm guessing. I'm gonna guess doubt.
Someone tried to kill you, Jessica. You get it? Forget about being in movies. It's time to act like a grown-up.
I had to wear a robe and lay down on a stone. There were lights, camera. It's not my fault. I'm not a bad girl. Why are you trying to hurt me?
Thank you, Jessica. Been a big help.
Because she's hiding something, Sprawl.
If you think of anything or if you need some help, just get in touch, okay?
Okay.
I think it might be a good idea if you went back home to
use better. Oh, yeah, okay, I get it.
I couldn't do that, officer. What if I got the part and I wasn't there?
Well, I didn't think I had any proof. You're right, the abuse.
It's the tale of this town, Cole. Lambs that go willingly to slaughter. Who the hell is that? Must be her lawyer. Certainly expedited her release. I don't like it, Cole. Why is she in such a hurry? We should follow her.
Oh god, now I have to follow because I fucked up, don't I? Now look, this is what I don't like about this game. Here's the thing. We've already proven that we already know that she was abused. We've already done that. So why should I have to shut up? Why should I have to say try to talk and do this at the same time?
Ballard is definitely up to something.
Oh, I thought you meant, like, physically where, like, which location. He said, where did it happen?
She seems to have made a remarkably speedy recovery. Why are you putting this...
Oops. Damn it. I'm dumb. I am Akari. I'm usually definitely streaming around this time.
It's the tale of this town, Cole. Lambs that go.
Yeah, that's what I thought he was saying. I didn't know we had proof of where it happened.
Lawyer. Certainly expedited her release. I don't like it, Cole. Why is she in such a hurry? We should follow her.
I forgot I was in a police car. All right, fair enough.
There she goes. Come on.
It's a shame it doesn't put me back so I can answer true to that question. So don't use the horn. Got it. Oh yeah, we were playing pigeon game for a while. Whatever the hell the name of the game is. A Topple Boyfriend.
Seems to have made a remarkably speedy recovery.
So even if you win, you still have to do this dumb following sequence. That's
too close, Phelps. Way too close.
Seems silly. Like if you do everything perfectly, you still have to do the worst part of video games. I love the rationale of this game too. They notice you if you start ramming into cars. It's like she sees somebody ramming into cars, like, oh, that must be a cop. Huh. Alright. Sweet Pat.
Get in there and see what she's up to.
Take cover at the door. What is she? Is she robbing the place?
Two club sandwiches. Thank you, waitress.
Enter the cafe without being seen. Seen by who? Where is she? There we go.
No, I don't want him taught a lesson. You know what I want. Well, then make someone else do it. You still know people, though, don't you? Then make some calls.
This guy right here.
Wilson's Hotel. Mr. Mark Bishop, that son of a bitch, lives in apartment 8 Old Street.
Fair enough, feeling it. 8:03.
Sure, I caught the film.
Alright, can I... Did she leave? Hey, Roma Dead. What's going on? Don't mind me. Just gonna go take this car right here. Police business. Unfortunately, no, not that I'm aware of.
LAPD, I need your car. Now.
Wait! How will I get my car back?
You can have my cop car. Probably should go back to Sleeping Dogs at some point.
So what's the story? I'm guessing she didn't stop for light refreshments.
She made a call. Sounds like Mark Bishop has a heap of trouble headed his way. I've got an address. Wilson's Hotel, apartment 803.
Oh, shit. You better step on it.
If he's got any sense, he'll be as far away from home as possible.
If he had any sense, he wouldn't have tried bumping off Guy McCaffrey's wife in the first place. Or he'd done the job properly. McCaffrey will break a fella's legs just for looking at his car.
What did you make of the kid? You believe her story? I think she was doped out of her tiny mind and given the casting couch. That fucking bitch Ballard sold her out.
So if Ballard was doing something...
It is pretty great.
Why did they try to kill her?
I think I made the mistake of doing, like, the DLC mission, like, immediately because I'm an idiot. And I sort of screwed myself out of enjoyment of the game. Puppies. Because we're a good driver. Also because I have an absolutely phenomenal frame rate. I have never played Watch Dogs. I would like to. Oh, what?
Take it easy.
Come on. Oh, that's true. We get to go out of the traffic. We get to go to Arson next? That'd be cool.
Ah, you're gonna kill someone!
Oh, homicide. Alrighty. Peace out, Remedied. I do like your style lately. It's like, come in, tell me a bad video game, then leave. It's like, it's succinct and to the point. Gotta appreciate that. A burglary was cut. Whoops.
You don't care who gets in your way, do you?
Not really, no. Go to burglary next? Oh.
Now look what you've done!
Do I tell you how to drive?
Wait, what the hell? I didn't do anything. Oh no, my score. I'm not gonna 100% it. Shit, I'm taking a drink. I'm glad the game ran for me.
I'm Detective Phelps. We received a call about a domestic disturbance in apartment 803.
Oh, detectives. Listen, Mrs. Bishop's pretty upset. Take the elevator and then left down the corridor. It's the last door on the right.
Left on the corridor.
Sounds like we're about to make it a hat trick of hysterical female witnesses.
I mean, I get it. From a story standpoint, I get it. But I also don't care. 803. No.
LAPD, ma'am. Are you in danger?
I'm all right now. You just missed them. Horrible, awful men.
Are you injured, Mrs.?
Mrs. Bishop. Gloria Bishop. Please, come in, officers.
Well, yeah, it's the 50s. Women didn't have much of an identity back then.
That's perfectly normal, ma'am.
Just look at this mess!
We'll take a quick search of the premises, ma'am.
I thought that
said
penis.
Take a moment to gather your thoughts.
I will. Thank you, officer.
Shane Smith. I would, no doubt... Isn't there a Matrix game? I would totally play a Matrix video game. But I think it was like the Matrix Online, wasn't it? Wow! All the Bible junk! Shots fired. Faces in this game are pretty great.
This is going to help us.
Okay, got a whole bunch of religious icons here, and they're sort of conflicting with each other. What's up, Chief? What'd you find?
This doesn't pertain to the case.
I remember there was a Matrix Online, but I think it was ended up being super bad.
Not everything here is going to be wrong.
I am one of the few people who, like, I actually liked all three Matrix movies pretty decently well.
What do you have to do to earn $20,000?
Lorna Hollywood. Let's just leave that there. There should be a grabbing butts mechanic. What?
Presented to Mark.
You know what, Sprawl? I tried to play Bully. I did. I tried and loaded it again, and the controls were absolute dog shit, and I could not get the controller to work. I think so, Akari. Yeah. A fiver. Just grab this. Like, buy a horse in that day and age with $5.
Don't think this is anything.
Brokeback Mountain. I never saw Brokeback Mountain. I think I tried to.
Looks like the old movie set downtown.
Like, I tried to watch Brokeback Mountain for, like, the first 20 minutes, and it's like, these guys aren't doing anything. They're definitely not doing each other. Which seems to be, like, the only thing people know about this movie. All they're doing is sitting on a mountain. It's like, look, I'm not gay, but, I mean, if we're here for, if this is what we're here for, you might as well get it done.
It doesn't appear to be connected.
You know what I mean? But then, like, every one in 20, 30 guys... ends up being the guy who enjoys it. I'm not gay, but. What is this?
I think it's smarter man than me to connect that.
What? I don't remember that part. At least not from the Let's Plays of it I've seen.
Optimistic, Cole.
Hey, we don't kink shame here in Rushstream. I'm just saying that it seemed like a boring movie. Oh, was that the... No, it wasn't. I think everyone did it. Something on the shelf. I saw something on the shelf. Do.
Hasn't given me anything to go on.
Oh, yeah, good call. Oh, good. Do I get to do another flashback?
Mermaid in the background. Silver screen.
Who are these men in the picture?
Oh, yeah, there's the...
Mark and Marlon Hopkins. They work together on occasion. That's Hopkins' shop.
All right, let's talk.
Those men. I think they work for Guy McCaffey. You know the name?
No. Why should I?
June Ballard is married to Guy McCaffey. Have you heard of her?
That slut. She's been badgering my husband for days.
Mrs. McCaffey alleges that your husband tried to kill her and her friend last night. I think you should tell us what you know.
My husband's a movie producer. This has something to do with his new picture. He doesn't include me in his business.
Oh, I was going to believe you, but then you did whatever this is. One, two, three.
You're lying to cover for your husband. Do you know what you'll get for aiding and abetting?
I've been abused and slapped, and now I'm accused of lying?
I accuse everybody of lying. Do I have anything to prove? Oh, a $20,000 check. Lorna Hopgood on the account of Mark Bishop. Yeah, this was made out to... No. No, that doesn't thing. This check was made out to Lorna Hopgood. Who the hell is Lorna Hopgood?
Sorry. My mistake.
So you're gonna leave a poor, helpless woman here on her own? And at the will of unscrupulous men?
Yeah, let me just check my notebook. Jesus, calm the fuck down. Oh. This is Gloria Bishop. Review evidence. Whatever.
Those men. I think they work for Guy McCaffey. You know the name?
No. Why should I?
June Ballard is married to Guy McCaffey. Have you heard of her?
That slut. She's been badgering my husband for days.
Mrs. McCaffey alleges that your husband tried to kill her and her friend last night.
My husband's a movie producer. This has something to do with...
I think she has an idea.
He doesn't include...
June Ballard said she had a deal to be in his new picture.
Mark repeatedly told her no. He had Joan Leslie lined up for the role. That's how he got the finance. June made all kinds of threats. She was very rude to me.
Very rude.
June Ballard.
We were both on the same picture a few years back. That's how I met my husband.
She's supposed to be 26. I can believe that.
Where can we find your husband, man?
He told me he would be on set. That's all I know.
Her face is very, very stern. I believe that.
Either we find him, or McCaffey's people do, Mrs. Bishop. If you care for him, you should make sure that we find him first.
I do care for him. But I don't really know where he'd go if he were in trouble. Hopgood might know.
Alright.
Why is your husband paying Lorna Hopgood $20,000?
Lorna? Marlon's ex-wife? Are you sure?
Yeah.
You're lying, Mrs. Bishop. It's some kind of payoff. You know exactly what the money is for and who it's getting paid
to. Well, no, she doesn't know that.
Do I? Would you like to prove that, detective?
Yeah, we don't have any idea what the money is going for.
Like I was mistaken. Your husband looks like he's being blackmailed. They obviously have something on him if he's prepared to kill to cover it up. Why is the payment going to Hopgood and not McCaffey?
Lorna works at a check cashing place in Hollywood. You need to ask Hopgood why he needs that much money in cash.
in cash like her.
Your husband was at a casting yesterday with a young girl?
She seems snooty.
Not that I know of. He told me he was looking at locations. The picture's been cast.
Blank, 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 blank. Okay, what did he say exactly? Not that she knows of. I don't think I have it. What does lying do?
You know exactly what happened yesterday, don't you, Mrs. Bishop? Been through it yourself.
I'm gonna call my lawyer. You have a damn cheek accusing me of that.
I don't have any proof that she knows exactly what's going on. Oops.
Sorry. Sometimes you have to shake the tree to see what falls out. Jessica remembered a mermaid. The mermaid on the front of the prop store. You better come clean with me.
This is a sick town, detective.
Yeah, it's a lot of money.
The truth is, my husband likes them.
And you think that's okay?
I was 16 when I first met him. Magician with film. I was 20 before I realized he was just a B-movie hack. But he's nothing compared to some of the monsters at these big studios. My guess is Ballard sacrificed her little friend. Happens to a lot of girls.
Wow.
Your husband is in trouble. It could go easier for him if you were more helpful, Mrs.
Wow.
He's a big boy, detective, and so are you. This is Hollywood. There's always a deal to be done.
We are awful rude. Alright, let me use your phone for a second.
Operator, message for KGPL.
Putting you through now.
Phelps, batch 1247.
How can I help, detective?
I need a location on a silver screen prop store.
Just a moment. Silver screen props, corner 3rd and Figueroa.
Thanks for your help.
Well, she is rude, but, you know, that's sort of to be expected. She just had an awful time of it. Chopping Molotov. I just go into this guy's house. No.
Help me out. Silver screen props is our next stop. Roll.
Alright.
An aging movie star, a wannabe starlet, and a movie producer's wife. We're finally rubbing shoulders with the almost rich and famous. And from the stories they've given us, clearly none of them can act.
Yeah, Senior's got the idea. It's like, yeah, everyone's rude to us, but... The geometry does not like my partner. All right, to the cop mobile. By the way,
Mrs.
all my
Bishop knows more than she's letting on.
She doesn't seem to realize how much trouble her husband is in. The LAPD are the least of their worries right now.
You think she'd have gotten the hint after those hatchet men redecorated her apartment?
Maybe all right. She's just
okay. Loyal. Okay, well,
she's in on. She didn't seem like your average giddy broad with nothing between the ears.
Well, she might just be trying to buy enough time for Bishop to put a couple of oceans between him and McCaffrey.
By the way, all my archive videos are getting blocked in Germany for this game because of the music. So if you're in Germany, the only time you're going to watch a Roar stream play L.A. Noire is live, I guess. Whoa!
Jesus, Cole!
Fine, everything's fine. Another shower starts. We need to go back to Fallout 3. Some rain must fall. Oof. Excuse us.
Take it easy, Phelps. I'd rather get there in one piece.
Yeah, I'm uploading them to YouTube. That's what I'm saying. When they're uploaded on YouTube, they are blocked in Germany.
I'm out
mean, not that, you know, I mean, as sad as that is,
goddamn maniac!
It, you know, I'll deal
Thanks
with
for
it.
The tip.
I'm still gonna upload them to YouTube. Oops. Yeah. Thing about Germany is I always used to get blocked from them whenever you, they have a weird thing about captions. Like if you put any music lyrics in your video, like it's like instantly banned. It's a lot of the reason why I don't put up my music request streams on YouTube, because it's not even worth it. Are those boobs? Those are boobs. That's awful weird for the 1940s. I guess it's a mermaid, so... That's a pair. What's up, buddy?
Phelps and Bukowski, LAPD. We're investigating the attempted murder of June Ballard and Jessica Hamilton.
Christ! I'm Marlon Hopkins. How can I help?
You hold casting script.
What'd you hear about that? I've got a little soundstage out back.
Lead the way.
He goes into a room with just a black couch. So, how old are you? Wow. You look like you're 16. Are you sure you're legal? Someone find me a little Brazzers logo I can stick onto my stream. At the bottom right.
I'm gonna take a look around.
What's this got to do with me? Don't try my patience, knucklehead.
Awful rude all of a sudden. Alright, let's look around.
Turn off the lights, Hopgood.
Why would I want to do that? Humor it.
Because I asked you to? Yep.
One-way mirrors. There's a room on the other side.
Okay, you can turn them on now.
Well, well. Find a way into that peep den, Phelps. I'll stay here and keep our pervert company.
Threw your hat at him. Oh. Just like we found in the car. All over the place. Does he, like, exclusively make, you know, Hidden Tribe films? A lot of pills. What do we got here? Don't hold your hand steady, please.
Doping a 15-year-old kid and abusing her in a screen test. What is wrong with this kid?
Why am I picking up every... I don't need to pick these up. I don't need... Here. Let's go through here. What, Sprawl? What do we find?
Can't be that way, Phil. Could fit a rat through there.
No good to me.
No, I believe it perfectly fine. This is a whole different thing. This is, we already found the victim of the car. Like, I get the correlation here. It's not, hey, we found a car. Also, this guy's a pedophile.
Probably.
Like, this is a whole different thing. Alright, how do we get into that room? Probably through this thing right here. I don't need this. Let's go around the other way, I guess. No, that's not what I'm saying at all. Whoa! I mean, in a way, Senior's not wrong. I mean, we should be sending this over to Vice. Jungle Drums.
Eighth and Francisco. Attention, Mark Bishop.
I mean, we're not, this isn't our department. We're not trained for this.
What happened to the film of Hamilton's screen test?
Los Diablos. Oh yeah, there it is, right through the a lot of perverted pictures. I seem to be stuck. I'm stuck. Get out. There we go.
I wonder if they saw this, how many budding starlets would still get on the bus to come to Hollywood.
Bunch of perverts. There's a clue outside. Is it this bottle? It is, isn't it? There's a bunch of these shrunken heads around. Is this literally all this studio produces? Oh, good. More of this.
Listen, I have to call you back. I got some business here.
Sit down, Courtney. This is Mickey. Mickey, this is Courtney Sheldon. What would you like to drink?
Scotch. Straight up. Hear you back at school learning to be a doctor, kid.
Yes. That's right, Mr. Collins.
You want to be a doctor and a dope peddler. Think you see a combination, huh?
Do you have a problem, Mr. Collins?
We might have. Yeah. Selling your dope to my boy Lenny looked like a good move, but Lenny has been supplying, wholesale. So to speak. The Bindle boys in this town aren't used to the juice without a little of the middleman taking its cut.
Lenny promised that with Ken. And Lenny works for you.
What can I say about Lenny? Oh yeah, it's a putz. And he's lazy, and he's greedy, but he's my wife's brother. How can you make a cake with those ingredients, huh?
This is an uncomfortable dinner.
Well, kid, the only way we're going to be able to make this work is to do some repackaging. We need to get the dope out of those dainty little cardboard boxes.
Surettes.
Yeah, surettes. Great. Put into a big vat so we can water it down.
I won't bore you with the chemistry, but it doesn't work. You're likely to kill even more.
Okay, listen. We want to buy you out, kid. I'll offer you $50,000.
That's a lot of money. Should do it.
Hey, you don't like my offer?
The other guy's like, this fucking guy.
Sheldon, kid? I think I want him dead.
Well, I should have taken the offer, buddy. Is that the only clue? Look at more of these stupid heads. God damn it. I can't read what they're saying if you keep purging them. I mean, I'm sure it was not something extremely game-breaking, but... Oh, yeah, Smart War. I wonder if I didn't care about it. I don't see any clues. In what way is it relevant? You got a lot to answer for. Marlon Hopgood, blue eyes, brown hair, age 44.
Do you ever do any work for Mark Bishop?
Mainly do work for the studios. RKO, Republic, Warner Brothers. So yeah, when Bishop was doing work for a studio, yeah.
When did you last see him?
Yeah, I'm doing work for his next picture. Still pre-production though.
That sucks. Yeah,
I've seen him around here in a while.
I don't know if I believe this guy. How you looking? He's a little bit shifty and his mouth is... What do you say? I haven't seen him around in a while. When would Hopgood have seen Bishop recently? Made out to Lorna Hopgood. No, because... Bishop's name in the film. Oh, that's right, yeah.
I know you're lying, Hopgood. Bishop was here, and you know exactly what he was doing and what he left lying around afterwards.
You come in here without a warrant, and now you start throwing your weight around?
Empty film or the regular film? Why? Film canister marked Mark Bishop, Jessica Hamilton. All right.
I have a drugged up 15-year-old girl, and you have chloral hydrate.
That one has his name on it, though.
You give me something, or I will break your fucking jaw, Hopgood.
Bishop was here with June Valley, my girl. A lot of producers and directors use this place. I'm not responsible for what goes on here.
This coward. I'm not responsible.
McAfee's men are looking for Bishop. We need to find him first. Any idea where he might have gone to ground?
If you really tried to kill McAfee's wife? My advice to him would be to leave town.
Do I have any... I don't know if I have any proof. I mean, he looks pretty straight-laced there.
You could hump a few props or sweep the floors if you got nothing better to do.
Hump a few props?
I'm warning you, Hopgood. If you give him up to McAfee and we find out about it...
Wind it back a notch, tough guy. I'm telling you, I don't know where he is.
He looked pretty the same, though. I mean, the first thing, he wasn't really stone-faced. He had that whole thing with his lips. It probably was truth.
What's the deal with you and June Ballard?
Look, buddy, I make props.
I did.
I hardly ever meet the talent unless it's something tailor-made for them, like a sword or something.
Let me look at his face. Looking at his face, he's not very stone-faced. His like lips are clenched. Like his face is just sort of... Let me look and see what he was actually saying. Between you and June Ballard.
You and Ballard are blackmailing Bishop. That's why it cracked.
You got nothing on me. My hands are clean on this.
Well, yeah, but no, we found the check.
I'm about done with you and your accusations.
That's all for now, Hopgood. We're taking you in.
Phelps! Roy Earl at Vice. Hold on a moment. This is clearly a Vice case. You've been roughing up my informant?
Hopgood is a Vice informer?
Yes, he is, Phelps, and a very important one. Look at that mug. Have you been upsetting these two officers, Marlin?
So we just drop it?
You do if you know what's good for you. You need to catch the movie producer before an angry husband does, from what I'm hearing.
I'll be making a full report to the captain, detective.
You do that, kid. We're all very impressed with you. Let it slide, Cole. Let's get at it.
Detectives!
Johnny Goldberg. You work for Mickey C.
That's right, detectives.
You wouldn't happen to know the guys who roughed up Mrs. Bishop earlier today, by any chance?
No, no. Not us. We don't do that kind of thing. It's the husband we'd like to talk about.
This is a police matter. You don't want to be taken in for obstruction of justice, do you, boys?
You could try the obstruction raft, but it won't stick. We could beat that.
You've had your 10 cents worth, gentlemen.
Bishop knows how the world works. Mrs. McCaffey hits him up for a movie part. Happens every day. Bishop takes it a step too far and tries to rub out Mrs. McCaffey. Naturally, guy is going to get upset.
What made you think Bishop would be here?
We figure he might be planning a little accident for Hopgood, too. Those two guys have got some unfinished business. You let us know if you find Bishop. Guy McCaffey can be a very generous man.
I'm only going to warn you once, gentlemen. Stay out of this. This is a police matter. We will be bringing Mark Bishop into custody.
At least he's polite. Kind of dumb. But polite.
But I'm a lot less polite, this smug son of a bitch. So let me put it in ruder terms that even a pair of blockheads like you might understand. The only reason that you don't have bars on your windows already is because you're small, Flack. And we don't waste our time on small. You stay away from Bishop, and you stay away from me. It's a cool thing. Now run along back to your boss so we can pat you on the head and tell you what good boys you are.
Look at his face.
Whoa. I'm thinking like your little pep talk.
I'll try for the tires. Keep your foot down.
They really don't want anybody getting to Bishop before they do.
Here, Cole.
Oops. Oh, shit. This is bad.
Hate to lose those fools, Phelps.
Oh, ho, ho, get wrecked.
I'm a little exposed here, Phelps.
Ah, you're fine. Did you get him?
Let's see him chase us now. On to the movie set, Phelps. Let's roll.
Oh, Christ. And they say work in traffic is like watching paint dry.
You know how to piss people off.
Hey, if they're prepared to gun down cops in broad daylight, McCaffey really means business.
Seems like we're the only ones who want Bishop alive.
I have a good mind just to let him go work on the son of a bitch. Oh, I knew I should.
Excuse me. Oh God.
I have a good mind.
I forget about truck gun. Forget that I actually had a police vehicle.
Police emergency, out of the car.
You're probably not gonna get it back. Real talk.
That's our job, unfortunately. They don't get to dole out the justice.
Straight through.
Nope.
You're a goddamn menace! Next left. Keep going straight.
I'm sure nipple rubbing works for a whole lot of anything. Unless you're in a completely different game. Whoa! That guy just
killed him.
Oh god. Everything's going bad.
What in the world?
Look out!
Look out for what? Something here. When did I say that? Was that on was that during Minecraft?
Straight through at the next junction.
Ah, he's fine.
Finally! He's starting to think nobody would show.
What have we got? The Third Street Gang and the Diamond Street Gang. The Mexican kids with nothing better to do than howl at each other. But no bloodshed so far.
Shit! Hope you brought plenty of ammunition, sir!
Sir?
What was that face? LAPD, drop your weapons!
I lost my hat. Gorp was here earlier.
Keep moving!
Get in cover.
How long do you think you can hold out?
Oh, hello. I should not be dead. Shit, shit, shit. Damn it. Flump. That was terrible. I'd be down for that. How far away is that? I don't know if I want to drive all the way there. Unless I'm like right around the corner. Whoops. This car has a lot better turning than my last one did. Let's do a little more.
Finally! We're starting to think nobody would show.
What have we got?
The Third Street Gang and the Diamond Street Gang. The Mexican kids with nothing better to do than howl at each other. But no bloodshed so far. Shit! Hope you brought plenty of ammunition, sir! Ellie!
out of here. I can't get into the truck. Is there a button that I missed? I believe you mean it's not, name of that game, Bulletstorm.
God damn it, here come more of them. That's it, I'm out.
Shit. That's a cop car, wasn't it? Doesn't really feel like a fair fight.
Your move, mister! Come get me!
Let's go around this way. So where's their police car? Is this not a police car? I thought it was. Oh.
I got
you. There we go. We're never gonna get the Vice.
Car 11K calling KGPL. I need an ambulance at 1624 West 3rd Street. Code 4. Shots fired and suspects are down.
I killed a whole bunch of people.
All units be advised. Code 4 on the major 415 on West 3rd Street. Suspects are down.
Alright, let's switch back to where we're going. We're going to the set. I don't know. I'm not sure about literally. And I know that what we did wasn't part of the case, so. Yeah, I noticed that. Yeah, I remember that. Literally. Not literally, figuratively. Whoops. I meant to thread the needle there. I know we don't talk about politics on this stream, but it feels like every major election, there's always like one underdog that feels like would be amazing. And it always just screws up every time. It's like, if it's not Bernie Sanders, it's Ross Perot, it's, you know, Ron Paul. It feels like every time. Maybe I'm crazy. But, fuck it. I don't want to talk politics.
There's a slippery bastard now.
Oh, hello.
No. God damn it!
Bishop, stop! I'm the one.
Get him, Phelps. I'll cover the exit.
11K calling KGPL, requesting assistance at 8 in Francisco, an abandoned movie set. My partner is pursuing suspect on foot. Code 3.
Can that shoot?
We're trying to help you, Bishop. This is all a big mistake.
I mean, you know, Phelps isn't exactly a marathon runner, so.
Hey,
It would be a travesty. But seriously, it's not talk politics.
McCaffey's boy, your choice. I didn't do anything.
I didn't do nothing. Oh God, that's so hokey. Have it fall as we're leaving, like Super Mario Brothers.
Get the hell out of here, you goddamn maniac! Bishop, that's enough! That girl made it all up!
Where'd he go? Oh, he's over there. God, that's so dumb. Of the set falling apart as we're running. Whoa, hello. Run, idiot.
You're under arrest for the attempted murder of June Ballard and the rape and attempted murder of Jessica Hamilton.
All right, I'll come quietly. Just don't kill me. If you found me, then McAfee's goons will too. Oh, we need to get out of here.
Oh, shit.
All right, but you stay close. Any tricks, and I'll save McAfee's boys the trouble.
Follow me. I know another way out of this place.
It's called Let's Fall Over the Side of the Building.
Christ, Detective, they're trying to kill me!
Who's they? Where am I getting shot from? Shit, get in cover.
Reinforcements are on the way!
How come that guy can shoot from cover and I can't?
It's this way! Kill them, for God's sake! I don't want to die!
McAfee doesn't make... LAPD, you're making a big mistake.
I could have done
There's
that,
no
I
way
guess.
Out of here. I thought you said you knew where you were going.
We have to jump for it.
Some cover.
You have to get me out of here.
Kill a cop, and it's the electric chair.
Where they at?
Can't hit him from this distance.
Oh, that sounds like shit. What, he can hit me, but I can't hit him? I'm using the rifle now. How was he killed? You better not start me up at the top again. There we go.
Get him over here! I'll cover you! Come on! The cavalry's here!
Those barrels at the base of the elephant column. They're full of gasoline. Shoot them. Where? Quickly.
The captain doesn't make the rules. You hear me? Stay down.
What barrels? I don't see any barrels.
You're covered, Phil.
Thanks, old guy.
LAPD, you're making a big mistake.
I don't see any barrels. No.
Stay in cover.
I don't see any barrels down there.
Is this really the best the captain's got?
Oh, that. Okay.
Find the cover.
There we go. I was looking at the other elephants.
Follow me. We need to get him to the car.
God, they're everywhere.
The other guy. Oh, he's way over there. Nice cover. Well, I mean, they were probably full of, like, you know, gas and pyrotechnics. He said they were full of gas, so they may have had to run generators. I don't know. Do they have those back then?
Get into the car. I can cover you from here. You're almost there. For the love of God, how many are there?
Are these good guys? Oh, they're cops. Yeah, it's true. Gas itself isn't extremely explosive.
Right there! Kill him!
Mostly the vapors.
We're done.
This is the 40s.
Now this is what I call a result. Mark Bishop, erstwhile film producer, an all-around piece of shit, catches a fast ticket to Quentin for statch rape and attempted murder, so he gets to spend the next 15 years playing sissy instead of sticking it to little girls. That is justice for capital J, Victor Phelps. Felt such a reputation, I'm not going to be able to hold on to you any longer. You're getting promoted. Go on, get your new assignment. It was good working with you, sir.
What about Wazowski over there? I guess you're not. Okay. Guess not. Look at this fucking guy. Hey, my new partner?
Phelps, Bukowski, this your work? Can I help you, detective?
Sorry, Cap. Didn't see you there.
Yeah, I'll bet you didn't. This is a traffic case. You need something?
I'm here to buy a drink for the two LAPD traffic cops who broke the back of Guy McAfee's private army. You don't have a problem with that, do you, Captain?
Go right ahead.
Get in. I'm buying.
I don't want to have a drink with this guy. This guy's a douchebag.
You'll like this place. A lot of movie people hang out here. You like jazz, Cole? The hopheads love it.
Sure, I guess.
Big bands and swing, I can understand, but this bebop palaver? How are you supposed to dance to that? This is Phelps, Leroy. Be nice to him. You'll like this place. They treat you right.
You like a table, boy?
What do you think we want to do? Stand at the bar like
I'll
chumps?
I'll get a table ready for you.
Don't look so happy to see me, Alphonse. I might get the wrong impression. Cole, this is Alphonse. He's a French Negro from Africa. Can you beat that?
The Congo.
A pleasure to meet you. Is Elsa singing tonight?
Yes, she is. She has the next set.
Come on, Cole. You can meet Elsa while they're fixing us a table. You'll like her. She's something else.
Maybe another night, Roy. She's pretty beat up about
something. Get your hands off me. Don't ever tell me what to do or what not to do, Alphonse. You got a nice club here. Don't spoil it.
But you will follow me, detectives. Just through the door.
This guy's a complete douchebag. I thought he was already married.
My only real friend, Harlan. We went through it all. You realize what he meant to me?
Of course I do.
You have no idea. You said it was construction work.
It was an industrial accident, Edison.
Elsa.
Elsa.
Let it go.
Are you going on?
Louis, for God's sake, he was my best friend. The only man who ever loved me without putting his hands on me.
Hi, Elsa. Here's someone I'd like you to meet. Cole Phelps, war hero and crime fighter extraordinaire.
And why would I want to meet another fascist from the LA?
Sorry about this, Cole. What an evening I'm having. First a Negro puts his hands on me, and then this.
Ooh.
Who do you think you're talking to, you German junkie whore?
Mike?
Don't you ever forget your place with me again. Do you hear me? Evening, Doc. How's business?
Sanguine. Louis, help me here. I'm gonna have to give her something before her performance.
Blow it off, Cole. These artsy-fartsy types always get a little flighty. Meet Dr. Harlan Fontaine, doctor to the stars. Mr. Fix-It to the mental wreckage of Hollywood. So what about that drink, boys?
Yeah, you kind of do want to just wreck this guy's shit. Oh, let's see how bad I did. Look at my vehicle damage. $100 in injuries. Yeah, I've done worse. 3 stars and promoted to homicides. Okay, I was worried it was frozen. Nothing important happened. So basically what's going to happen is now we're only going to be doing, we're going to be learning all about traffic cases. So we're going to investigate this murder and learn all about the car and what, where
right,
it was stolen from.
Take your seats. Let's get this over before lunch.
Hey, it's this guy.
Clyde Rose of the Homicide Squad has decided to take early retirement. We will all miss Floyd and the steely edge he brought to his police work. The department has arranged a wee drink at the Galway Arms to quench the mighty thirst a man gets from 25 years of police work. Floyd's departure leaves a place at the top table, and the chief has seen fit to promote Cole Phelps from burglary to the homicide desk. Stand up, Phelps. Take a chair.
So yeah, he says from burglary, so burglary got
You're in the major leagues now, Sonny. Rusty Galloway, the fine lawman of the old school.
Oh, good. This guy. I was hoping he was my partner.
Your first case is the murder of a woman, found last night in Berwick
Hall,
the signs of the werewolf. Get out to the scene, lads.
Can I put burglary back in? Is there like a mod for that? Putting a desk on, you know, patrol the street and attend street crimes. Okay.
Do you have the address?
Been all over KGPL. It's off Temple's town. Belmont and Glendale.
This guy sounds like a wet blanket.
Hey, fuck you, asshole!
Survived
the war for this.
Stay for it.
Hey, don't mind me.
So it was cut super early.
I'd rather you took the lead.
I'd rather you get the fuck out of that car. This isn't how we do things. This is what we're taking.
Thank you.
Get out of that car. This is our car. There we go.
That's no way to drive.
I can't find a garbage truck. This is the best thing I could find.
Whoa, if someone reports this?
What happened to Rose?
Parker wants the chief's job. Word is it's either going to be him or Thad Green. So they're both clear for death.
Where does that leave you, Galloway?
Leaves me saddled with a chump like you, Phelps.
Whoa, rude.
I didn't ask for you, and I don't want you, so keep it to yourself. See if you can learn something about seeing how a real cop operates.
What did he mean by the werewolf?
Medallion. The Daily News came out calling him the werewolf killer. The Examiner came up with the Black Dahlia.
Were any closer to catching him?
Not a chance. 6 months and hundreds of guys running down leads, we got nothing.
I think this has anything.
Sorry about that.
Jesus, Phelps!
No, I don't. 90% of murders are domestic, Phelps.
Look what you've done.
The guy gets into a beef with his wife, he takes it too far.
Partner, whose name I've already forgotten.
But cutting someone in half and leaving him off is...
Rusty.
Sir, step up the car, please.
Be careful with it, copper.
I'll be very careful. You know what? You can take that car.
Because of the war. You should know that. Guy gets to kill people every day in combat. Comes home, expected to take lip from his wife. What do you think's going to happen?
It's that simple.
Like I said, most of the time it is.
Watch where you're driving, you maniac!
The ocean. I don't think...
Take the next right.
I don't think the ocean is available.
Stay on this road.
Watch it. Sorry! My partner isn't the greatest driver in the world!
I was kind of worried that would actually ruin the,
crime scene is just right up the dirt road, detective.
That's the guy. What's your beef with this guy, Phelps?
Kill who, Rusty?
How about a scoop for the Examiner, Galloway? You could use some good press.
Another tramp, another message. Is the werewolf back in business, boys?
That guy's
smart. A mother asshole, a sister? How about showing some respect for this poor woman? Let us do our job, and Detective Galloway will give you a statement later.
He's good, Rusty. He even sounds genuine.
That's Phelps, guys. The war hero. Defending the honor of murdered humps.
You're used to it, Phelps.
Moving along, guys. You got your pictures, you got your headlines. A scram.
Yeah, pretty much. Super excited. Uh-oh. Blood. Oh, it was a murder. Oh my god. Holy god, it was... Whoa!
Trollman, this your beat?
Yes, sir. Well, part of it. Kids park here, they use it like a lover's lane. It's a working neighborhood. Some trouble, but nothing like this. It's known locally as the Moors.
You were first on the scene?
Yes, Detective.
No one's disturbed the body?
No, sir. We cleared out them vulture reporters so Pinker in the coroner could work. They're waiting to talk to you.
Go house to house and see what you come up with. What can you tell me about the shoe prints?
Men's size 8s. Pinker lifted impressions for me to compare back at the lab.
Contaminate the crime scene. Just drive over the body.
brand new. Can't be the one used on the body.
Okay. In my defense, these aren't modded boobies. She probably used this to brush her terrible pubic hair. It's like a fucking mullet down there. Excuse me.
Looks like some kind of puzzle or part of here.
If you say so. What? This is just some hopscotch. Oh. Anything else in here? Let's investigate the body. Oops. Let's not do that. Investigate.
Cause of death? Could be the head injuries. She has been badly scarred.
Yeah.
The cuts look superficial. I'll know for sure in an hour.
Goodbye, cruel world. Put it down. No ring.
What about this wound on the finger? Something removed. A ring, most likely. I assume it was taken post-mortem.
I think you can check it later and it does something. I don't fucking know. What's going on with this writing here in the middle down here? Fuck you, BDT.
What does the writing on the victim mean?
BD, like Dahlia? Tex? Your guess is as good as mine. Could be something to it, or it could be the killer's trying to throw you off the scent. Either way, I'll run tests on the lipstick.
Any idea of the time of death?
From the temperature, I'd say after midnight. I'll confirm with you later.
Alright, well, let's talk to somebody, I guess. What the hell are you taking pictures of? Okay, whatever, buddy. What do you think, sport?
Any ideas?
The crime scene, isn't it? Oh, just stand there, take a look around.
What the hell are you doing? That's definitely the murder weapon because it's bone dry. This is the puzzle. Is there anything over here? A cigarette butt. Nope. It's a crime scene, isn't it? I thought I grabbed all the clues. I got the footprint. I got that one. Did you find something? No. I'm pretty sure I found all the labeled things. This is her thing. This is the puzzle piece. I'm pretty sure I grabbed everything. Oh, I didn't further investigate. It's a hard puzzle.
Steal a
table lighter.
It's a pretty cool lighter. It's not right though.
If you get to the bomba, man could die of thirst in a case like this.
Best of luck to you. I figured it was fine. And now I think I got all of them. I checked everything on the corpse.
Force injury to the face.
Good
call.
Could
be anything from a baseball bat to a lug wrench. I'll have more details after the autopsy.
There we go. Excuse me. Body check. No, it was the blood force. All right.
Great. How are we gonna look getting around in this thing, Cole?
We're gonna look fine. Just shut up.
If we survive this, it's gonna be a miracle.
Alright, let's go down to the La Bamba Club. What's up, Jade? You missed a telephone boyfriend.
My money? Copycat.
We can't rule it out. We need to work the evidence.
You'd love that, wouldn't you? Big head to hang on your wall. Caller of the decade. You can work in evidence from BD cases.
Oh my god, this thing is not going fast enough.
Turn back, we're going the wrong way.
No, we're fine. Actually, no.
There's
we're
a
not.
Difference, Rusty.
Oh, yeah?
I just started working it today.
Okay, Oddshot. What's more likely? The werewolf comes back around, leaving us alone in the courts?
He clearly has a thing for power. Power over women. Why not power over the police department as well?
Let me finish, though. A guy opens his mouth again after 6 months of stewing. There's some opportunist who's been reading about the BD figures. He'll rip out the MO and get himself a freebie.
That's not totally fantastical.
You know, an examiner of the Daily News might be good at coming up with monikers, but they're terrible for police. There's a reason we didn't get the son of a bitch after the short murder. It was them, locusts.
Where do you think the werewolf killer is now?
Dead by his own hand, stationed somewhere else with the armed forces. San Quentin, another town, another country, who knows? So, Phelps, I understand you want to turn this into a big case, but it doesn't work like that, all right? A case will come and find you. You can't make it something an egg, understand?
So you don't think the werewolf has continued to operate in the Los Angeles?
Whoa!
Calm down!
There goes that, seesaw.
You're making your right connection.
Officer needs help. Bank of America, 7th and Olive. Officer needs help. Bank of America, 7th and Olive. A 211 in progress. Fired.
How far away is that? Hold on. Oh god, is that? God damn, that's miles away. I'm not going to that. I was doing okay for a while.
I don't know about you, but I feel more comfortable with the siren on. What do you think?
I was doing okay. Alright, let's take this shortcut. To answer who said that, take Peroy, we got Osan. I could make a seat there. Whoa!
Whoa there!
Do you ever shut up?
But driving is a fun. I enjoy driving. Besides, how will I ever get better at driving? If we don't practice. Yeah, Oka-san. Oka. The bird who likes pudding. And we also got the Yuri option. Yeah. Roy being rude. Again. Fucking hell. Where is it? Is it up here? No, it's on the other side. a lot smaller than I was expecting. I mean, I was expecting, like, the I Love Lucy Club. In fact, it's, like, super tiny. Holy hell.
Gentlemen, what can I get you?
Phelps and Galloway, LAPD. Were you working here last night?
Yes. How can I help, officer?
You can start with your name.
Garrett Mason.
You're the regular bartender on nights?
I'm a temporary barman. I work for an agency. I fill in at bars across town.
Do you remember a woman who came in here last night? 5'7", about 110 pounds, blonde hair, about 40 years of age.
You mean Celine Henry?
Yes. Do you know anything about her?
I don't, but the owner, Mr. McCall, serves her most nights. Would you like to speak to him?
I would.
He sits at the back of the club, wears a hibiscus. You can't miss him. Is there anything else?
Is my partner going to get a drink? Yeah, okay. God damn it.
Pour me three fingers of rye.
Three fingers?
Where's that goddamn place?
You got to admire him. At least he freely admits he doesn't do any work. Where's the hibiscus? Is that this guy right here?
Detective Phelps, LAPD. We're investigating the murder of Celine Henry. Do you know her?
Celine? Sure, I know her. She and I and Jacob, her husband, we go way back.
She was here last night?
This voice was not...
Sure, she's a regular. Celine is... was a lovely woman.
Yeah, his lips were not moving.
Was Mrs. Henry here with anyone last night?
Not at first. Celine already had quite a head start.
And she attracted attention?
Certainly. A few gentlemen became very enamored with her and her students. One guy in particular.
He's got a pretty straight face there. Yeah, I believe that. Tell me more.
You know him?
No. He's been in a couple of times.
Did they leave together?
Yes. At around 11. If it helps, I made the guy's license plate.
Thanks, buddy.
I think this could be a great help, sir. Thank you.
I don't think this guy has any reason to lie to us. Which is good, because I don't have any real evidence to pin him on, I don't think.
Mrs. Henry appeared to be missing a ring, torn from her finger, but not her wedding finger.
Celine always wore a red garnet ring. The large side. Larger than life, like Celine herself.
Did she have it a long time?
Sure. Since way back in her flying days.
Did her husband buy it for her?
No, it was before Jacob.
Okay, now. Okay.
I think you know where the ring came from, and I think you're gonna tell me.
Okay. I bought it years ago. Carried a torch for Celine in those days. As I always have.
So you
man never knew about
it. So you wanted to bang Celine.
You know the husband?
Sure I know Jacob. He was in the Corps. He met Celine on a furlough and married her when the war was finished. Put up with a load of shit.
Do you think he killed his wife?
No. No, not in my opinion.
Yeah, he's swallowing, he's looking around. Yeah, you're hiding something.
So if it wasn't Jacob, then you probably let her out of here with the guy who killed her. How do you feel about that?
Whoa.
Stole the attitude, will ya? I tried to get onto Jacob. I rang him up. Asked him to come pick her up, like usual. But he refused. She picked some night to push him over the edge. I rang him back around 11:30. Got no answer.
That's an old-timey phrase, Senior.
Thanks, Mr. McColl. You've been a big help. One more thing. Would you have an address for Celine?
142 North Union Avenue. God knows I had to send her home in enough cabs to remember that.
Where is that goddamn place?
somebody in here is really upset about the waitress.
So, how's your tuna fish salad?
That pretty much is Cole.
You want a tip? Refill my coffee next time.
Let's get out of here.
Are you...
Hey, what's the hurry? My stool was just starting to warm up nicely.
Phrasing. I don't want to hear about your warm stool. Oh, phone.
Hey, honey, what time did you get off the waiting table?
There we go. Use the... There we go. I got it, bro. I'm on this.
Operator, give me dispatch.
I'm on top of it.
Putting you through now.
Yeah, why do you think I said it?
1247.
Goddamn.
How could I help, Detective?
I need a registered owner on a license plate. 2BOY8899.
Yes, Detective. I'll need to contact the DMV. Shall I relay the details via KGPL?
Please. Thanks.
What the hell is this thing? Oh, it's a cigarette. Can I buy some cigarettes? Put a coin in that phone? Probably not. Probably called the operator. Oh, there's our car. Actually, is this our car? Do we drive the corner? We didn't drive that here. Ours broke.
Getting around in this thing, Cole.
You guys remember? I'm pretty sure the corner car we had, we destroyed.
You find the booze helps you get through a working day.
Sharpen
at the Bumpkin Club, give Nicole the...
A smart lawyer might use that to throw out anything you collect. A
smart man might know it's unwise to stand between the patient and his medicine.
As long as you're not falling over, Rusty, I'll let it slide.
That's mighty kind of you, Phelps. No, you picked the wrong job with a healthy thirst of vengeance.
We owe it to this city to do the best we can in this position. As homicide detectives, that responsibility is all the more serious.
Always the politician.
It's not political, it's practical. Maybe the men combing Hollywood Boulevard after the Elizabeth Short murder were more interested in sniffing out booze than the clues that would have led to her killer.
Yeah, well, if only you'd been there, choir boy.
I hate this
teammate. Betty Short would be alive, the Japs would have spared Pearl Harbor. Our ancestors wouldn't have tasted the forbidden fruit.
Minor syntactical error, Detective Galloway. I never claimed to be able to prevent crimes. I only suggested a proficiency in solving them. Guess that's the drink slowing you down.
Wow.
My God, brother, oh brother. Worse than I could ever have imagined.
Oh, hello. Let's see. Okay, yeah, I'll take that one. What is this? Oh, the Bomber Club. Well, his buddy is a douchebag, so... 6th
Street in Lindy Place. Unit to handle code 3, identify.
Buddy cop's pretty terrible. No, my lack of memory, I wish, was a stick, but I just... I just literally think I have ADD. It's becoming more obvious to me every day that I just have ADD. Like, adult ADD. I wish I could say I'm just making it up, but... I'm just... It's just getting worse. That's a shame. So I'm not the Owen Wilson of this cop relationship, is what you're trying to say.
Keep on going through here.
It's nice that this police thing is on the way to the next thing. I don't have Alzheimer's. I mean, I may, but it's not time for that yet. It's a little early. Yes, I'm a millennial? I guess. I thought it was like Generation Z or Y or whatever the hell it is. My wife is Generation X. It's dumb. Whoa. Guess we're close to the shootout. I don't think I'm a millennial. Oh. Way to go, officer.
That alleyway leads to the rear of the building, sir. Someone's gonna have to climb up and take him down.
Good luck. Don't let him get a beat on you like I did.
Alright. Good thing I showed up in a hurry.
Got the worst climbing
stuff. Wait. Oh, I gotta climb up the pole. Hey, you. I can't shoot. I can't aim up. You're lucky. Whoa, oops. Oh god, I thought they were farther away. Whoops. I thought they were running. So when the hell is...
How are we gonna
Generation
Wow. Well,
dumb.
Officer needs help. Shots fired. Officer down. 6th Street and Lindley Place. 6th Street and Lindley Place. Unit to handle code 3. Identify.
This is car 11K. We're on the help call.
Whoa!
11K. Shots fired. Officer down.
Trunk gun. Well, I had to rush, because they were... I don't remember how to get into the trunk gun. They showed it to you, like, the first mission, and then...
That alleyway leads to the rear of the building, sir. Someone's gonna have to climb up and take him down.
Good luck. Don't let him get a beat on you like I did.
Alright, let me check the... Oh, here we go. Ooh.
Get over here, will you? This is as much fun as it looks.
Yeah, I'll take this.
We'll get cop killers are the worst kind of scum.
Marbles. I have no idea what this generation's called. Oh, I resized the window. Shit. Come on. Where's this bed? 1 second, sorry. I seem to have resized the stupid LA Noir. That's actually really kind of bad. Move. Move the fucking game. Alright, we'll play with a handicap. Here we go, I'll just play from the OBS window. This isn't disorienting at all.
You like killing cops?
We did it. Good job, us.
You gotta be kidding. We're driving this?
Of course we are. I don't remember other guy caring that much about which car we had. I mean, we drove a truck right. Half the time.
How are we gonna look? Getting
right, let me see if I can get my window back. I can't. It's really stuck. Alright, I guess I am actually going to be playing from my OBS window. I'll just resize things. There we go. Alright, whatever. This will be fine, just really awkward as hell. Oh, except my chat window is covering up my map. Awesome. Let's put the chat here then. Fine. Terrible. Okay. Yeah, look at the Greeks and shit. Oh, that's what Jade said. Yeah, look at all the old civilizations. Look at the Phoenicians. They created a common alphabet. This is so disorienting. Oh my god. It's like I'm looking through... It's like I'm driving with binoculars. Or with glasses that don't fit me. Because my main window is about half lost in the... outside of the monitor. I can't feel annoyed. I tried. I think the only way I'm going to fix it is by restarting the game, and I don't have the patience to do that. I do have glasses. I generally wear contacts. I'm not doing to that. No, that will make it worse. No, I'm not going to restart the game. I'm going to finish this mission. And then I'm gonna go. I probably should go anyways. I need to go to work in the morning. But I'm gonna finish this mission first. Because if I don't, then I'm gonna forget all what happened by the time I come back tomorrow. It'll just be a little awkward. It's fine. It'll be like playing Spore without eyes.
Get out of the way! There's a madman on the loose!
What are you talking about? We've had like four interviews, it feels like. No, it's fine. It's fine. I'm just whining. It's not as bad as I think. Let me try one more time to fix it. You think that... Oh, wait, can I just do this? Can I Alt-Tab, maybe? Like, maybe I can make it full screen? Let me see one more thing. Gameplay, display. Hi, Blue Mac. How you doing, buddy? Sorry, we're having some technical problems. What if I do this? And apply... Oh, hello. It moved. Okay, I could work this. This will work. It's not great. Wait, what if I move it back? Move this next one. There we go. Why? Ah, here we go. It's still not perfect, but I'll deal with it. It's fine. Much better.
Are you liquored up? Jesus, Phelps, you're terrorizing these poor slubs.
Slubs. This guy is such a douche.
Okay, next corner, hang a right.
Alright. Oh, hello. What'd you drop? Am I liquored up? I am not. I'm just a little tired. And having... The window resized a little bit, and I couldn't figure out how to get it back. But everything's fine now. Okay, so this is... whose house again? Locations... I got a little distracted. The Henry residence. And Henry... is... okay, the husband of the wife who died. Now I remember.
I'll try the back door. Right here, sir.
That's what she said. We're dithering. What do you mean? Very poor memory. I'll freely admit it.
Side window's been jimmied. Looks like somebody's creeped the joint.
Alright, let's look for clues. On the left page of your journal, the shadow had some missing blocks. I don't know, because we're gonna find some,
You said I had to go back, Doctor.
Fire, Zark. Fire. They allow you to confront your past.
You said the house would be empty.
Are you taking the medication I have prescribed?
You said the house would be empty. I heard them screaming.
Circumstances were unfortunate.
This guy.
My colleagues had made all the necessary arrangements.
You said the house would be empty. You're killing me.
The deaths were unfortunate. But you have dealt with death before.
You said the house would be empty! How can I find peace?
Oh my god. I do declare. Family burned to death. So he burned down the house and ended up. Shit. That's rough. Oops. Ooh, hello there.
Seems irrelevant.
It's relevant. Alright, never mind. What'd you find, buddy? Apparently that's irrelevant too. Female shoe. Oh, hello.
Size 9s. Above average for a lady.
Wasn't the size of the shoe we found there size 9? I mean, it wasn't a high heel shoe, but... God damn it. Stupid LA Noir is just a little too low now, so I keep clicking out of the window. So rude to court. You gotta be here for you to give him shit.
Burglar used a pry bar. Why did you kick the door in?
You think I'm gonna climb through a broken window in a $30 suit? You got another thing coming, Buster.
Well, let's. Yeah, he's not gonna climb through that window. Are you kidding?
Jacob are obviously having problems. It speaks to motive.
Or went to bed earlier.
Ways against it being Jacob could be something to go on.
All right.
If I just drank like this, you'd be feeling the back of my hand.
Call in burglary and get technical services out here. I'll talk to the neighbors.
Don't take all day about it, Phelps. I get nasty when I'm thirsty.
That's nothing. Phelps? This guy, you're not his boss.
Galloway, homicide, badge number 564. Requesting technical services for a suspected 459 at 142 North Union.
I already checked this room. Corp to bed. The hell is the command? No. Although she had... Oops. She had the same hairbrush at the scene of crime. Dog shampoo? No. Why do you think, Sprawl?
Tiffany?
Ooh.
The rest of this stuff is junk. Might explain the missing ring. A regular Amelia Earhart in her day.
Oh yeah, there's the ring. Okay, so there's all the evidence. Let's go talk to the neighbors. Something fun going through all the commands. Alright. Let's go over here. It happens. It could be you. What the hell? Hey. What's going on?
I knew it wasn't safe around here anymore.
LAPD, are you acquainted with Celine Henry, Miss...
Horgan! Jennifer Horgan.
Horgan.
I've known Celine for more than 10 years. Our children grew up together. What's going on, officer?
Did you see Mrs. Henry go out last night?
Well, I'm no busybody, you understand, but... Celine had been drinking. And she and poor, long-suffering Jacob had a terrible row. I think Jacob may have given her a black eye. He stormed out and she went back inside.
Did he come back?
No. Celine was listening to music and shouting until she left around 10 p.m. She was very drunk to have been driving. But she is not the sort of person you can stop from doing something when her dander is up. What is this about, officer? Is Celine all right?
She did.
I'm afraid Mrs. Henry has been murdered, ma'am.
Murdered? Oh, my God. I'm afraid I need to go and then sit down.
Are we not going to talk to her about it? She's the next door neighbor. We need to get more clues. Or maybe not. Alright, never mind then. It's a red herring. You're off the hook. We go into her house? No, it's boarded up. Alright, so there's no more evidence then. Can I go to the next door neighbor on the other side? Are you in a clue watching mood today, Sprawl? It's the second clue reference you've said today. Not that I'm complaining, because clue's just fantastic. Hey, look, your Amazon shipments came in. There you go, just gonna spread it across the lawn for you. Think you're home? No? Alright, I don't... Clue's a fantastic movie, don't get me wrong. Okay, let's look at... What do we got? What do we got? Jacob Henry's apartment. Did we get that? Oh, that's right, we did.
See what Jacob has to say for himself.
I don't think Jacob is our man, but we should see what he has to say.
Okay, thanks, partner. Good team.
You've got to be kidding. We're driving this?
Yes.
Great. How are we going to look getting around in this thing, Cole?
Yeah, you're right.
Jacob Henry had a violent argument with his wife last night. He's looking more and more likely.
For my money, the broad keep the house looking like that's probably deserved.
Whoa!
Skipper says bring him in.
Rude.
The hacks off our backs for a while.
Fine by me.
So it ain't the werewolf killer after all. Good to see you come to your senses, Cole.
I always said work the evidence. I only stipulated a connection to the BD killer as an avenue of investigation we should leave open. And as far as I'm concerned, it still is.
KGPL 20 Century Unit.
Oops.
Citizen reports a man with a gun.
Yeah, he's a douchebag. Ah, damn it. I think I've tried that exact same jump before, and it does not work any time.
You're making a right at the next intersection.
I feel like that should work. If this was Grand Theft Auto, it would work. Hell, if it was Red Dead Redemption, we could drive our horse up there. I feel like it should work.
You need to take a left at the next corner. Up ahead, you turn left.
A horse is, well, it's not technically a vehicle, but you do drive it, so. Oh god, that would be amazing.
Okay, Phelps, we go in hard. Follow my lead.
Follow me, my lead, my foot. Why are we going with pistols? I mean,
Jacob Henry?
Yeah. Who's asking?
LAPD. You're under arrest for the murder of your wife, Celine Henry.
Murder? Celine?
Save the dramatics. Oh my god! RKO, pal. You got a bigger problem.
What the hell are you talking about? You come in here, you tell me that Celine is.
Take a seat, Mr. Henry. We're gonna have a look around, and then we'll talk.
Jesus, I'm sorry.
Like, I know he's their primary suspect, but we have no idea that he's armed. We didn't have to come in with guns blazing.
I get the slightest flight.
Right? That's what I'm saying. Ooh. Okay. Not the murder weapon. God damn. Dude. Chill out. He's already freaked out enough.
He'll be back.
Move the pencil? Oh god. I was hoping to draw a wiener, but... Thanks for the clicking out of the game offer. Need you to do something about my wife. Thanks, Blue Mac. This isn't really a... God damn it. I can't... Ah! It's not fixed. So I really have to get everything... I get it. That's what he says.
The oldest problem there is. What to do about the old lady.
let me do something real quick, because this is pissing me off. Display, graphics... There we go. Just make it the full fucking screen. Kinnaman! Alright, can I click out now? I cannot. There we go. Much better. I have to completely shade in everything or the Scantron won't pick it up. Can I go out here? No. Oh.
I don't think this is any use to us.
You sure? Okay. You're accused of murder, but the screwdriver and this baseball bat, they're fine. Oh, are the bars new now? Alright. Alright, buddy. Let's chat.
So who could have killed Celine? Where did she go last night?
A bar, I suppose. Look, I don't know.
Listen here, shifty eyes. Still. Blunt force trauma. There's more Stuarts. Did I miss some other things?
That's all? You got more in that goddamn book? Spit it out!
I thought I got everything. Maybe not. Get up, Cole. Get up from the... There we go. Am I missing some, Oh, in here. There we go. Good call, senior. Gotta get all the... Oh. Someone's on their way out. Oh, size 8s? No.
Size 11s.
There we go. Good call, senior. So he was not the guy at the car. This is important.
So who could have killed Celine? Where did she go last night?
A bar, I suppose. Okay. I don't know.
No, we this is a lie because we know that we have an alibi that they called him. Yeah.
You know where she went, Jacob. You're lying. Why would I help you if you keep lying to me?
Look, I'm telling you, I don't know.
They called him like several times.
We know she went to the Bobble Club.
The bartender there. He calls me if things are getting out of hand, and I go and I bring her home.
Still, Stevie, does he even have a TV?
He called me last night. I said no. Phone rang a couple more times after that. I ignored it.
Maybe.
You have to live with that.
Yeah, you sure are, buddy. All right.
When did you last see your wife, Mr. Henry?
Last night. I went to see her. We talked. Things got a little out of hand. I left.
That sounds pretty legit. But he is... I don't know. Doing a lot of blinking, a lot of looking around. I think that's a doubt. Do we have any proof that he actually did all this, or he did anything differently?
We meant to believe that, Jacob. It isn't looking good for you.
That nosy bitch from next door, Jenny Horgan. She'll tell you I left. And what time?
What did I... The neighbor didn't say anything about that. Whatever. Motive for murder.
Why did you kill her, Jacob? Things will go better if you come clean about it.
That's a lousy thing to say. I never gave up on my wife.
I don't believe you, Jacob. I think you didn't have the guts to do it yourself, so you had someone else do it.
You want to back that up with something, Big Mouth? Huh?
Yeah, there's a thing in the kitchen. Death threat note.
The note by the phone suggests you meant her harm.
You want the truth? Truth is, I was sick to death of her. I was trying to have her committed.
We're still going to need you to come downtown, Mr. Henry.
We can get this all down on paper, Jacob. How you got fed up with your wife and how you figured killing her.
Kill my own wife?
You was a loss of the tramp, and you just couldn't stand it anymore.
Shut your goddamn mouth.
So now you're gonna tell me you loved her? Ah, the DA goes all gooey over remorse, Jacob.
Oh! Whoa, 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 whoa. I'm not ready. I'm not ready. Shit. I don't even remember how to fight. I don't remember how to fight. I'm going to be out cold in a second. I don't remember how to fight. Guys, this is bad. I remembered halfway through.
Call it in and get a squad car dispatched. And check for messages. Keep old Slugger your company.
I forgot you had to hold the right mouse button. Hey, you want to talk about it, big guy? Guess not. No, that's how you're supposed to fight. You're supposed to right-click spacebar to dodge. Where the hell is the phone? There we go.
Operator, give me R&I.
Kick him in the balls.
Putting you through now.
Phelps, 1247.
How could I help, Detective?
I need a patrol unit to transport a suspect back to Central.
I have a patrol. I have a police car. Can't I just take him there?
I have a message from the coroner. Do you wish to be put through?
Of course I do.
Yes, ma'am.
Carruthers.
It's Phelps.
I've completed the autopsy. Several wounds to the head from a blunt metal instrument. Closest match would be a socket wrench handle.
So the cause of death was the blunt?
No, the blows to the head surprisingly were not fatal. Death was from hemorrhage and shock from the fractured ribs and multiple injuries caused by the stomping.
Anything else?
He's some kind of sex fiend. The tissues of the anus were bruised about 1/8 of an inch, but no trace of semen in the anus, vagina, or stomach.
Thanks, Doc. Operator, give me R&I. Any word on an owner for that vehicle? License was 2BOY8899?
Yes, Detective. The plate belongs to a brown 1936 Pontiac. Registered owner is one Alonzo Mendez of 402 South Fremont Street, apartment 16.
Thanks. Any other messages?
One, Detective. From Captain Donnelly.
Wacky backy.
He wants any and all suspects returned to Central. Interviews to be set up immediately.
Got it. We're coming in.
Okay. Let's go do that then. No. Wrong car. We're taking this one.
You gotta be kidding. We're driving this.
So they want us to go. Let's go to the apartment.
Alonzo Mendez. Sound like a man who moonlights as the werewolf?
Don't sound like a man I'd let my daughter anywhere near.
You've got a daughter.
Spend enough time drinking, Cole. You'll find yourself with any number of things you don't want when you're sober.
Whoa.
So that's why you never sober up.
Exactly.
Carruthers said she took a real pounding.
Maybe if he had been a little firmer in the beginning, he wouldn't be in this situation now.
I imagine that Neanderthal routine is a big hit with the ladies, Galloway.
Women love me, Phelps. I have no complexity. They know exactly what they're going to get.
This guy... I mean, even for the 40s... Holy hell. Fucking rusty, right? Whoa!
Come on!
It's fine. Everything's fine. So I don't really know... I don't really want to go into huge detail, but what do they mean by the bruising? Like, 1/8 of an inch? I don't really know medical shit, but that doesn't seem like it's that... It is a crime, you know, it's terrible that there was bruising there at all, but... That's not very big, is it? 1/8 of an inch? That's true.
Mendez, apartment 16.
Deep tissue bruising. Okay, that's fair enough. It's been a long time since she's had anything that small, so wouldn't know. Her last husband's number, we can call him. The hell is this apartment? God.
Don't bother knocking, just kick the door in.
18. Where the hell is 18? Or do you say 15? Alright. Is this the one? No.
Take a look around and see what you can find.
Why did I listen to him? I was just gonna knock. Don't listen to this asshole. See, the thing is, though, I don't really have anything to prove, though. I mean, I have a fantastic sex life with two kids, so I get all the sex. And obviously, you know, it works out, so I could have the tiniest wiener in the world, and she's satisfied, and I am too, so I am perfectly okay with my dick.
I don't think so.
Are you sure? You sure, Phelps? What the hell is this, T? Put it down. The hell does that mean? Like, are you saying I have a horse dick? Which, that could be alright. I do, Mr. Bing. Oh. God damn it. You guys are terrible.
I doubt it.
Proper gun safety. Oh. Hello. Thanks for following next time. I think we found the murder weapon.
Consistent with Celine's injuries, and the blood can be typed.
We have the murder weapon. Better get Pinker down here.
Why keep it? Why not throw it away?
Think these clowns are geniuses?
Door.
Thank your stars you caught a break. Captain Donald would begin to like you.
Guys, door.
Hey, what gives? LAPD, you're under arrest. Do not lose that son of a bitch. I'll go get our wheels.
Mendez, stop right there.
Hi, next time. How you doing, buddy? Thanks for the follow.
You don't need to do this, Alonzo.
Where'd you go? There you are. Dramatic chase music. Well, it's Second Amendment. He's allowed to have a gun. That is not the right car. You're just waiting for the opportunity, weren't you? Oh, I want that truck.
Spin him out.
shit.
I got an idea. Get him next to my window, Paul.
I'm working
Keep
on it, buddy.
Inside his vehicle, and I'll stop this son of a bitch.
No. Oh, you'll disable the vehicle, then. Okay.
Don't go to sleep on me. Get me back in clothes.
Get in there. Shoot his tire.
Keep it steady and I'll try to bust his tires.
Come on. There you go. Whoa.
You're under arrest for the murder of Celine Henry.
Give it up, LAPD.
Yeah, it wasn't exactly too difficult to catch back up to him. I should have lost him like 3 times.
I ain't saying a goddamn thing.
Good voice acting.
You did a grand job, lads. Phelps. That's quite a way to acquit yourself in your first outing as a homicide investigator. It seems the city has a new and vengeful guardian. Considering the evidence
against
the
suspect
and the thoroughness with which a report was compiled, I foresee a safe passage through the courts, and the DA agrees with me. Brutality on a scale such as this deserves retribution. The people and the press of this city.
Oh, super rude. What the hell? Alright. Only a little bit of vehicle damage. We're fine. 3 stars. It's all good. Even if you did leave Jacob sweating in central lockup. Oh, oops. Yeah, we did do that, didn't we? It's fine. That was a cool scene. It's fine. Thank you for the follow. Oh god, I think we're gonna... Oh no. You're another woman. You're gonna be in trouble. You're a woman at night. Oh, really?
Galloway. Got it, Skipper. Yeah, I'll bring him. My partner.
What have we got?
It's such a douche.
New case. White female dumped in plain sight in the grass at the end of Hill Street. Hats are all over it. Captain's trying to fend him off.
That sounds awfully similar.
The first rule of police work is make no assumptions until you've seen the evidence. Skipper wants you to have your newspaper case on the column.
God.
I think I know the place where they found the lady. It overlooks Sunset Boulevard. Let's go.
All right, let's get out so it can save. It probably saved already, but...
Got a stakeout down on 2nd later tonight.
Poor guy must be going crazy.
Where does it save? Like, we used to go out in the middle of the street and it saved just fine, didn't it? I can just wander around until it gives us a save message. Try and knock this guy's hat off. Maybe it'll save it. What's up, buddy? are you doing? There you go. There you go. I got your hat. He's just leaving it. It's like, nope. Press B to call your partner. Can you?
Galloway.
Really?
I need you.
I did not know that.
I'm busy here, pal.
Good to know. Alright, I'm sure it's saved. Whatever. Is that blood? No, I don't think so. Is it?
I'm gonna get good and tight. Come fresh.
Why did he bleed? Terrible. I can't actually pick that hat up, can I? I wish I could. No, just step on it. Alright, that's enough. It's bedtime. It was fun. This is a good game. Even though I'm not very great at it. Thanks y'all for hanging out. We'll probably play more Hatalful Boyfriend later. Tomorrow. But for now, it's bedtime, so peace out, guys.